Dog Day Afternoon. On a hot summer day in 1972, two men walk into a bank in Brooklyn for what is meant to be a 10-minute robbery. Sonny, played by Al Pacino, wants to steal some money to help pay for his husband's sex change operation, while Sal, played by John Cazale, is there to help. The holdup is eventually botched, and the bank becomes surrounded by police, transforming the scene into a hostage situation and media circus that begins to elicit anti-establishment sentiments from Sonny and the growing number of spectators.
It's all a whim. Rob a bank.
I had a plan.
WNEW plays all the hits.
I was having some trouble narrowing down my choice for a New York City film, but then in honor of the recent passing of the legendary Sidney Lumet, I decided to go with Dog Day Afternoon, a great film in every element of its construction and a great indicator of 1970s New York City in just every single element of its filmmaking.
Right, and it's based on a true story that happened in New York. Yeah. And I love how this true story and is reflected in the aesthetic of the film.
Yeah, from the very beginning of the film, which is sort of a montage of like a pastiche of all kind of life aspects of New York City, to the shocking conclusion, there's a very tangible, lived-in feel, a very naturalistic feel to every single element of the filmmaking. There's a lot of handheld, not shaky, but a lot of handheld cameras that really adds this documentary feel to it, because like you said, it's based on a true story and they're trying to reconstruct, you know, what actually happened. It's also really well expressed in a lot of the dialogue. There's kind of a Robert Altman quality to it where a lot of dialogue overlaps and people are talking over top of each other. You're not really sure what's going on, just like it would be in real life in this high-tense situation. And if you actually watch the film with subtitles on, you can see that the actors kind of, you know, strayed a little bit from their lines, adding this a little bit of improv feel, a little bit of real naturalistic feel to it, and just adds a whole other layer of enjoyment to it.
How about letting the people out of the bank?
I dare keep me alive. I'm going to let him out.
Sir, can you tell me what the situation is?
All right, who has to go to the bathroom?
Yeah, and you really need capable actors to pull that off. Mm-hmm. And who more capable than Pacino? Mm-hmm. And then you have one of John Cazale's five performances, period.
Yeah, which I'll get to in a little bit, because first, obviously want to talk about Pacino, a great actor, a great performance, but one that's starkly different from the film he did just prior to this, The Godfather Part II. Mm-hmm. It's almost like these are two different people because of how vastly different those performances are. And then, like you said, John Cazale, only starred in five films, all of which were nominated for Best Picture. He plays this enigmatic character that you know, has these real moments of intense passion. You know, he screams at people and he tells Sonny, I'm ready to kill at any moment that you want me to, you know? But then he's also kind of simple-minded as well. When asked if there's a particular country he wants to go to, you know, he thinks for a little bit, and then he says, Wyoming. And it's really funny. There's a lot of these really inherently funny moments in the film as well. So it's just really great. It's a really powerful and worthwhile performance.